Let's now go over to the Q&A session. We used to have Olivier. Now I have my colleague Matthias sitting at the director's desk. So, Matthias, did we get any questions on the chat? Okay, we have already one. Okay. Okay, so let me just repeat the question. OPUS or camera, can the roll cutters and the F-series use the same registration marks, files, etc.? Very short question, one that we have received a couple of times, but it's a very long answer, so bear with me. So, using the same registration marks on a camera for an F-series or on a roll cutter is what we call twin workflow. So twin workflow has two versions. We have the twin standard and the twin light. Now, for the twin standard, this is generally an OPUS cam roll cutter combined with an F-series, and this is where we use the S-Class OPUS cam, make it compatible with the workflow that we use on the flatbed. So you can use the barcodes, you can use the same registration marks as on the flatbed, and it will go automatically. So the advantage here is load balancing. So either you have your F-series doing all the print and cut jobs and cutting through, or you have your roll cutter doing all the contour cuts and the flatbed doing all the cutout, or when your flatbed is occupied doing rigid material, you can easily do all your roll material on the roll cutter. So this is twin mode. So you have the necessity of using an OPUS cam. You will use GoSign and GoProduce. However, for twin workflow, you will need to have an upgrade towards ProPack. So ProPack is an addition to this specifically for twin workflow, where you can use the same files, the same functionality like on your flatbed, on your roll cutter, and you need to, of course, do a little bit of manipulation in your jobs. So this is important that this is only done with ProPack. Now, we also launched beginning of this year Twin Light. Now, Twin Light is the same idea, but the other way around. It's nice when you have an F-series and you only need to buy an OPUS cam to increase your production capacity. But the other way is also important if you have already a roll cutter, not necessarily a camera, but you want to invest in an F-series and make sure that you can use the same jobs you use on your roll cutter on the F-series. So with Twin Light, we're actually making the F-series compatible with the roll cutter. So for people having a Summacut or an S1 or an S-Class T or an S-Class D, the Twin Light will be interesting because there you will have your barcode generated for this. You will have GoSign again with ProPack because you need to remove the complete flex cut functionality there. So your roll cutter is only going to do contour cutting. And then on the flatbed, you're going to do your cut through or basically the complete job as well. But this makes both of them compatible. So important here is that you have a ProPack on your roll cutter, but also a ProPack on your flatbed because, there's a flatbed just in front of me. To also have ProPack on your flatbed because on a flatbed to have this production workflow, you need to have the ProPack for GoProduce. So long question, sorry, short question, long answer. Hopefully I didn't bore you too much. Do we have another question, Matthias? Okay. So the question is the software available as an add-on or to be used with older cutters? Yes. So the S-Class 2 is supported, the Summacut is supported, and the S1 is supported. But any older units, and I'm looking in S-Class 1 SummaSign, so units which are more than 10 years old are no longer supported by GoSign. This is just purely because GoSign adds a lot of functionality that is not supported by the hardware of those roll cutters. So GoSign supports S-Class 2, S1, and Summacut at the moment, not the older generations. For this, we still have Winplot on the website.
In addition to that,
Yeah.
Is
Yeah, good question. Is GoSign offered on the S-Class 2 from now on? Basically, yes. So, if the unit is, let's say, held in stock by the reseller and it still has all the driver CDs, you will still see Winplot on the CD. But if you go to the website, you can easily download it. It is also so that we want to reduce our carbon footprint, so we are going to, let's say, no longer put in a CD together with the roll cutter, because the latest versions are always available on the website. So keep looking at our website for updates in terms of software, because then you will have newer functionalities. So important is, in future, carbon footprint, it's important for the environment, so we will no longer be bundling CDs. You will always be able to go to our website. I've talked to many people before, they always go to the website instead of inserting the CD. If you don't have an internet connection on that computer, you can easily download it from another and put it on the USB drive. So this is important to know. Is it possible to prepare a second job in GoSign while the first one is in process? As long as GoSign is communicating with the roll cutter, so it's sending a job, you can't, because then it's blocked. Once it, frees that connection, you can add. So if you have a very long job that is going to be cut, it could be that halfway through the job, all of a sudden you can open up a new job, prepare everything, and then send it after that job is finished. But as long as there is data communication, there is no way of opening a job and using this in GoSign. So it is semi-parallel working, so you can, as long as there is no communication, you can. You saw that in the print and cut part. In the print and cut part, you saw that all of a sudden you went from your job to the scanning icon. Well, at this moment, it just is free. But because we are in a barcode workflow, this is, of course, taken over by the software waiting for a barcode reaction. So. Good question. When will Opus Extra be available in Onyx? I hope very soon. It's going to be linked together with an update from them. They have an SDK. We already tested a couple of beta versions, which are proven to be stable, working well. So once they are ready to launch, they will launch it. Important, what I did not mention yet, Opus Extra is available on the S1, but with a firmware update, it will also be available on S-Class 2 as well. So it is not only linked to the S1, but also to the S-Class 2 that we have today. So just look and on the updates for Onyx. I don't have a specific date, unfortunately. Is it possible to work with two or multiple units simultaneously? Oh, that's a difficult word, sorry. Simultaneously with GoSign. Not at the same time. It's always in succession, so in series. If you have multiple devices you're going to need to communicate with, we have cutter control with the barcode server that can support up to, if I'm not mistaken, 12 or 16 cutters. If you look at GoSign, this is going to be a separate install of GoSign for every cutter. If you want to work, of course, simultaneously, if you want to work in series, then basically you can use one version. And it's free of charge, so you can install it and use it. It's just a pro pack that needs, that is a payable upgrade. So, more questions? Nope. So, no more questions. If you still have any, don't hesitate to email us or use the form on our website. keep looking at our YouTube channel. Next month, we have a new webinar planned. Date is not yet defined, but it's just next month. And it's going to be focusing on something new. So I hope you will tune in. And yeah, with this whole pandemic going on, I hope you all stay safe and see you next time. Bye.